Okay, now folks, Dr. Samdu Chhetri is here, and this is Sansar Pokhar up here. Tari Pokhariya dekhai do, badhiya se lambai chaurai sab. This is Sansar Pokhar. It's an important one. And now, the history of this, according to Tibetans, now Tibetans, sir, Sansar, the word Sansar, does it sound similar to us here, Tibetan word?
Yes.
Which word? Loudly, sir, so that the voice is picked up.
Samsara.
This is Sansar Pokhar, where the Tibetans call Samsara. This is the spot, this is the lake. Just nearby is a stupa, in which the local folklore is that people saw a king and king queen would come and sit on a lotus flower. And one day that flower shook, and the king and queen stopped coming. That's the folklore. And that stupa is surrounded by a moat. Now, according to Tibetans, that moat was filled with sesame oil. And sesame oil, and that sesame oil overflowed and produced a lake which freed Padmasambhava from
what, sir?
From Samsara. So, folks, this is your Sansar Lake. Now, this is in Lakhisarai town. We have got 51 lakes. But all the holy, what do you call it, prayers, chupra,
wait,
all the holy prayers, Lakhisarai, jo bhi visarjan hota hai, all the, what do you call it, statues and all, when they, what do you call it, finish praying, put the statues in this lake. This is the holiest lake, and I used to wonder, out of the 54 lakes, why was Sansar Pokhar the holiest? Why was Sansar Pokhar the holiest? Folks, the Tibetan story, Padmasambhava was freed from Samsara. And I will be taking to Dr. Samdu Chhetri to that stupa. It is just around 300 feet from here, and my videographer Amit, his house is here, and his ancestors were the monks, I most probably up here. So folks, this is your Sansar Pokhar, where Padmasambhava was released from Samsara.
It's huge.
And 3 years ago it was cleaned. It was a beautiful lake. I have that video with me, but just now it's a water hyacinth. Tibetans, you must overtake this. You must take this over, get it cleaned up. This is your Lake Rivalsar. What do you think about Lake Rivalsar?
So there's no connection. I mean, I don't know who found that space. Given the fact from the book that you've been referring and trying to find locate spaces, gives a very clear indication that Padmasambhava was from this land, was born here. All the events that has taken place, all the important events have happened here. There's no doubt about it.
So that your 125-foot statue in Lake Rivalsar, Tibetan, my friends, that statue should be in Lake Sansar. Thank you very much.